Welcome to Fight Day at the Paddock. There's a bit of confusion as to who is going to take on this Goose. The Goose is notorious for being a fucking psycho. There's a lot of dodgy stories. If I was a cow, I'd hesitate to lose my life too. It looks like Shirley is going to have a crack at winning the fight purse though. She looks moderately confident. Oh, the Goose charges. Shirley tries to headbutt it, but the Goose is too strong. It is the best defensive fighter in the world. Shirley says, "Do one of yous want to jump in?" Her friends are like, "No fucking way. I'm busy. The Goose says, "What do you want to do?" Shirley mumbles, "Fuck it," and decides to tap out. The Goose really wants a worthy opponent that it can take on. This wanker is thinking about it. He is definitely thinking about it, but it looks like Gaz is gonna have a go. He has a record of 0 wins and 83 losses. He's got a heart of gold, but he truly does suck. I think he knows it. He knows it deep down. He tries to attack the Goose from behind. The Goose is like, "You craven cunt," and delivers two vicious pecks to the brain. Gaz immediately pisses off to go look for a hospital. Whoa, I reckon he could end up dying from those wounds later. He's totally out of it. He doesn't know what day it is. He doesn't know his own name. He's fucked. Look at this. The Goose has almost cleared the entire paddock. It needs to take on a lion or a crocodile or Floyd Mayweather. This has all become way too easy. It looks like Gaz is being a shifty wanker again, sneaking up from behind. It's just getting sad. All the Goose has to do is look him in the eye, tell him he's pathetic and no one loves him. Gaz starts to cry. Game over. Physically, mentally, you can't beat the Goose. You just can't. You can't fucking do it.